Similarly, the end of space,
high planet,
which contains the millions and millions of solar systems, it comes out from space just like the crystal comes out of water. It is merely a process of crystallization. So understand space as your basic existence. And the indweller of space is the same as yourself. You are the indweller of your constitution, who is at the same time the indweller of the space. Just as the space in this hall is same as the space outside. When you understand that the hall is built in space and the space is never built in the hall, you can remember that space existed before this hall was built, and the same space remains after this hall is removed. Similarly, the space in you, who is the indweller, but there is the demarcation of understanding. For example, you can understand yourself as the indweller of your constitution as well as the indweller of the total presence. It is the same thing, the indweller of the same space. If space wants to talk itself, talk to itself, it prepared its own machine. Space wanted to look at itself, it prepared its own machine. If space wanted to listen to itself, it prepared its own machine. If space wanted to divide itself into two, one part to eat and the other part to be eaten, it exists in two parts. It created its own different constitutions, its own involved machinery. This is the machinery which you call your constitution and my constitution. No part of this constitution has the capacity to speak or see or hear. It is only the indweller who can do all these things. And from the indweller, the layers of the constitution are formed. It is for the purpose of utility to the indweller that these are formed. So, it is the one will indweller, the one who is existing as many in all these constitutions. Just as the one space is existing as the different spaces in different houses. Yes. That is the next understanding we are made to understand. This is called the fivefold division of the human constitution. Then you have the five energy centers which maintain the five states of existence. For example, you have your base center, which is called Mooladhara, which is the basis of the solid matter in your constitution. As long as your Mooladhara is functioning properly, the solid tissues of your constitution run healthily. When there is something wrong with the Mooladhara, then there is everything wrong in the biochemistry of the solid tissues of the body. Then there is the second center, which is called the navel center, or the Manipuraka Chakra. It is responsible for the liquid content of your body. As long as this center in your spinal column is properly working, you will feel your thirst whenever water is required. The water will be properly distributed in the body to serve the function of maintaining you. The moment this center is disturbed, the water economy of the constitution goes wrong. Sometimes we may have too much of thirst as a disease. Sometimes we may not have thirst at all. And the water we take in will be deposited in some part of the body in the form of dropsies and swellings. And there is the third center, the center of fire in you, which is responsible for the temperature of your body. And the constitution having its supply of calories of heat. That center is what is called the spleen center. It is called Swadhisthana in yoga. It has its automatic regulators of temperature. When it is too cold outside, it produces more heat in your body and you will find your body hotter in winter. When it is too warm outside, it reduces the heat in your body by perspiring. The result is, in summer you will find your body less hot. So this center is providing automatic regulators of temperature in your constitution to make you live. Then there is the next center called the heart center, the Anahata Chakra, which is the regulator of the gas. That is the air regulator of your constitution. It is the center of your respiration and the peristaltic activity of your constitution. For example, the heartbeat, etc. And then the next center, the throat center, which is called the Vishuddhi Chakra. It is the center which links you with the space in which you are living. This is a little bit difficult to understand. The passage between the space in which you are and yourself, the passage between yourself and space, the gateway between your consciousness and the space, is existing in this chakra. And space is a pool of sound principle. And when it is disturbed, there is what is called the sound vibration. That disturbance we are producing with the vocal cords. We are producing the voice, which is the sound vibration, and we are listening to it. So this is the next center. The five centers are finished. So the center for solid, the center for liquid, the center for fire, and the center for air, and the center for space. The five centers are well arranged in your constitution. And there is the sixth center, which is called your bro center. Your bro, it is called Ajna Chakra. It is linked up with the mind inside and the mind outside. We know the mind inside, but what is the mind outside? It is called the space mind, which is working the whole creation from space into existence. So the space mind outside is linked up with the mind in our brain, with this center called Ajna Chakra. This is called the sixth center, with which you have to gain the mastery. Then there is the seventh center, the head center. It is called the Sahasrara, or the thousand petaled lotus. That means a center of thousand consciousnesses working as the thousand rays of light from within yourself. But this center does not belong to you. It belongs to nature. You are permitted to exist there when you have removed all your blockages of the vehicle. As long as you exist there, you do not belong to yourself, but you are the universal consciousness, called the Lord Consciousness. When you once again descend into the lower stage, you can exist as yourself in your own vehicle to satisfy with your presence your wife and children. And you can be existing simultaneously. When you are an expert in handling with mastery all the spiritual layers of your existence, you can exist in the thousand petaled lotus, not as a person, while the whole constitution is working. The mind and the senses are working, the daily routine and the activity being attended. Your wife may believe that you are existing to her, your husband may believe that you are existing to him, your children may believe that you are existing to them, but it is the all existence that is existing in your name. This is the purpose for which the spiritual constitution of the human being is made.
Für die ganze geistige Konstitution des Menschen.
This is the ultimate perfection of creation. This is the goal and this is the accomplishment of human birth. This is a part of the understanding of the spiritual constitution of man. If we have to cover the whole subject, it takes 7 full lectures of 2 hours each. But now that we have made a sampling business of each, and also the trend of the journey of the soul, the purpose of the journey, and the experience of ultimate perfection as accomplishment. This is, in short, the epitomic atlas of the spiritual human constitution. Thank you all. Our love towards others is the love of God that exists in us. Love is not something which is expected from outside. That is something which is expected from within ourselves. It makes a manifestation as a transmitting pole, never as a receiving pole. As long as we are expectant of love, as long as we are on the receiving pole, never feel the presence of love, because we are made up of love. Our consciousness is a crystal of love. Unless the crystal is fused into liquid once again, we cannot experience the love of God, because it is never objective, it is only subjective. So the more we manifest what we call our love towards others, we experience the love of God. Because the word our love, when we use it, is a false term and an ignorant term. Because it is love of God that manifests through us. When we are traveling in the ocean, if we are supplied some water of the ocean in our room, if we say, this is my water, is it true? Similarly, what we call love is God's love when we express it towards others. When we expect from others, it is only a word and not love. This is the mystery of the love of God. Some others count the solar plexus as the second center, which I called the navel center, spleen center as the third center, whereas some others consider in the converse direction, that is, the second center as the spleen center and the third center as the solar plexus, or the navel center, which regulates the liquid of our constitution. No, the first chakra is called the base chakra, with different authors. Solar plexus are the same. The energy centers lose their balance by our deviation from the normal path of existence. Our behavior is the result of the resultant consciousness, and the energy centers work as the base whirlpools pools of our behavior consciousness. When we make violent diversions and deviations in our behavior from the natural courses and tendencies of living, that is, if we misbehave with our food and drink, or sleep and work, then only the energy centers will be disturbed. The only effective method to rectify them is to rectify the deviations in behavior, just as any defect caused by a wrong connection of electricity can never externally rectified unless the connections are disconnected and once again made right. So the rectifying process includes the rectification of the daily routine, suitability of our work with our temperament, and the tuning skill of ourselves to our environment, and the regularity of our activity. These are the only effective measures that can once again bring back the required change. Without rectifying these aspects, if we use special techniques, There may be a temporary palliation sometimes. Even with medicines also, sometimes there may be a temporary palliation, but a great tension is produced on the energy centers as a result. And a total distortion takes place in course of time. Instead of using any special techniques, the safest method is to revert to the natural process of living.